Hare Krishna, Jai Srila Prabhupada, welcome to the devotees. Today we are in the ninth day of the introduction. So today we are going to discuss what is this material world, what is the nature of this material world. And today, previously also many times we discussed that the perfection of life is that when we attain the supreme abode, that is the perfection of the life. So here it is also discussed few verses how this spiritual world can be attained. So what is the process? It is also mentioned here, and also it also talks about what is the nature of this material world. Why we cannot be happy, and then how our time can be engaged, in what way if we engage our time. Here also we can become happy, and how we can lead the life. Those all the things very briefly it is explained here. In the 15th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, there is a verse: Udvamulam adasyakam ashvadham prahur avyam. So in this sloka, so the material world is nothing but the reflection of the spiritual world. Means you can say perverted reflection of the spiritual world. So it is given in the example of using a banyan tree, aswadham. Shakam means the branches, the moolam means the roots. So if you go to any reservoir on the banks of the pond, no, on the bank some big trees will be there. But if you see the water, the tree looks like it is inverted. But in the same way, whatever is there in the spiritual world, in the material world also, it is in a perfected reflection manner, but it is all temporary. There it is all permanent. That's why this material world is exactly the reflection of the spiritual world, but in a temporary manner. This also given one more example here to make us understand. So in this material world, everything we think that it is a reality, but it is not so. Even if you go to desert, no, there are many places we can see a mirage. Mirage means the water body in the clouds, no, that image will be there, but far from the distance it appears that there is a water body over there. So in the desert, now due to thirsty, no, many animals, no, they run towards that mirage, thinking that there is some water to drink, to quench their thirst. But they travel this mirage, that mirage, and like that, continuously they'll be in the hope to get the water, but they'll not get the water. That's why in this material world also, always we think that maybe this may give happiness, that may give happiness. Always we live in the hope, because it is a perverted reflection of the material world. So why? Because we are not able to be happy. This is explained in the next sloka in this introduction. Nirmana moha jita sanga dosha. Nirmana means always we'll be trying to keep some designations. And this moha due to illusions, no? So always we try to anchor for those designations. In reality, those are temporary. Like I want to be boss of this company, I want to run this business, I want to make this much money, I want to do this many projects. Like that, so many anchorings and so many anchorings will be keeping. Ultimately, those are all connected to the only body. Once we leave this body, all those will vanquish. Nothing will come along with the body. These are only just to satisfy our body and our desires. So when we keep the desires connected with the Lord also, we can purify those desires. In the 26th page also it is mentioned, avyakta aksharam iti uktas. Means this avyakta means this unmanifested. this spiritual world is always existing. It never manifests and destroys like this material world. But we should not have any doubt on this. That's why this verse is suggesting this spiritual world is eternally is existing. The more details is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam also. Then we may get one question, how we are so many times is talking about the spiritual world, then how we can attain spiritual world and what is the process is discussed in the 27th page. Antarkalecha mameva smaran mukta kalevaram ya prayati madbhavam yati nashti antar samshayaha atar samshayaha. Means Lord is personally saying, so we can go to the spiritual world, we can attain the spiritual world. Anybody who goes to the spiritual world will never come back. In that you should not have any doubt. Samshayaha means without any doubt. This who is declaring? Lord itself is personally declaring. That's why. So what we have to do to get that about? This antarkale. Antarkale means the perfection of our entire activities of the life. We get only a fraction of seconds at the end of our life before quitting this body. That time smaran, whatever we remember, according to that we'll get the body. That mukta kalevaram means if you think about the Lord, then we will get the body which is similar to the Lord. If you think about anything else, like for example, in our house we kept one pet dog and we are so much fond of that pet dog. Always whenever we get time we stay with that pet dog. So if at the time of death, that antarkalam is at the fraction of seconds we get before quitting this body, if that time if you think about that dog, I'm leaving this, I'm about to leave, who will take care of this dog, who will feed them, who will bathe them, who will take out, like that if you think, no, then naturally we will get the next life this dog body. That's why we should practice whenever we get time from now onwards only. So what is the guarantee that definitely we'll think about the Lord at the time of that? All of a sudden it will not come, no. Anything practice only we can get. Even many English proverbs also says, no, practice makes man perfect. Similarly, Prahlad Maharaj also says that Kaumaram Acharam Prayet. From the childhood only we have to practice, we have to give time for these devotional practices. Suddenly, all of a sudden, it will not come. So, in the old, many people think that in the old days, let me practice, now sufficiently earn the money. You can see many old people now they are not able to move, some are bedridden. Some are hands will not cooperate, body will not cooperate, mind will not cooperate, and there'll be a lot of sufferings in the jara, old age time. So that's why when body is properly fit, every day we should give some time for this understanding the spiritual practices, then we can bring perfection to the life. So why we have to associate with the Lord also is discussed in the 27th page, because Lord's body is Satchitananda. Satchitananda, Satch means eternal, Chit means is full of knowledge, Ananda means is full of business, full of bliss, full of Ananda. Ananda means bliss. But our body is Asat, Achit and Nirananda. Asat means our body is temporary, Achit means we are in ignorance. We know only knowledge which will help us only to how to get our bread, butter, like food and shelter. That is our knowledge. Real knowledge is what is this creation, what is this body, how this world is running, who is maintaining, how this is. That is the real knowledge, not the knowledge which will give our food, shelter, clothes. That is only just to maintain the body. Then Nirananda. Nirananda means we cannot be happy always. Sometimes we'll be happy, sometimes we'll get distressed. Why? Because in this world nobody can become happy completely. Why? That is also discussed in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita also. because this world is considered to be dukkalayam ashashvatam, that verse also will come. Slowly we'll discuss elaborately on that. Because always in this world now we are living hope against the hope. Okay, today I'm studying engineering, maybe after that I'll get some job. After getting some job, I will purchase a nice home, I'll get a beautiful wife and children, I'll start some business side, and I'll have this one, I'll have that one. We'll be keeping so many plans. Sometimes that plans will come favorably, sometimes that plans will not work. Because of that, we'll sometimes feel distress and morose. Because this anytime in this world, only people can live with the hope. But we cannot live, because if everybody wishes are happened, then where is the question of the God? That's why we can only make the plans, but we cannot execute plans according to our will. That's why we'll always will feel nirananda in this world. So the process of quitting this our body and how we get the another body, that is also briefly explained here. So based on our activities, either we get higher body, means either we shrink or we rise this body. This called rising means it says urdhagati we get, or we shrink means adhogati. Either we get the better body or whether we get the lower body. Lower body in terms of consciousness, lower body in terms of the different lower species of the life. This human body is considered to be a junction. So this is a very opportunity whether we can upgrade our life or we can degrade our life. So how this can happen? Based on the our activities we perform in this life, that will decide. That we cannot decide on our own what body I want in the future. But if you do the devotional service to the Lord, then there is a guarantee that we will get the body according to the wish, because we are practicing as per the scriptures. Then naturally there will not be any doubt in that. So always we are talking about the spiritual world and material world. So spiritual world is considered to be the 75%, 3/4 of the entire creation. This 1/4 creation is considered to be 25%, 1/4 of the total creation. Out of that, this earth is a very tiny planet. In this material creation, there are so many innumerable universes are there. We can see in the sky, we can see astronomy, we can see so many calculations. Out of that one, we human being is very tiny. There is a next verse also. Yamam vapi smaran bhavam tvad ante kalevaram tam tam evaiti kaunteya sada sadbhava bhavitaha. Here it is stressing again what is told in the previous verse also. Based on our smaran, our thinking only, our future body will be decided. So if we suddenly as I mentioned, it cannot come, that thinking process. So every day we have to give some time. So most of the time we don't know which one to read, and because of that we will try to read many like materialistic kind of thing, like newspapers, novels, some nasty magazines. In that our time will go on. So naturally, you know, what we read, what we think, what we hear, what we talk, or with whom we do friendship is called sangha, and all this influence our character, our nature. That's why we should be very careful, and that what we are seeing and what we are reading, what we are hearing from others. So with whom we are talking and what we are talking. So with whom we are doing friendship and what kind of food we are eating, these are all greatly influence our entire body mind mechanism. These are the basis of our thinking, feeling and willing. It is nothing but the function of the mind. That's why we have to be very careful in this aspect. Then based on that automatically our life will get purification. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also in the Chaitanya Charitamrita he mentioned Maya Mukta Jivera Nahi Swata Krishna Gnana Jivera Krupaya Kaila Krishna Veda Purana. Due to our ignorance, no, we think that these things are giving us happiness and we will not give importance to the which is the real knowledge of the scriptures, Puranas, Upanishads, Vedas. At least we may not have that much time to understand the Vedas, Puranas, Upanishads, Vedanta Sutras. At least in this life, if you every day chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra as much time as possible and read Bhagavad Gita, at least this much is enough to realize the God, to understand the God and make our life successful and bring perfection to the life. So many people have a misconception of the spiritual life. Many people people say that if you do God, worship God, if you do only service to God, then what happens to our daily needs? But many times, you know, people have misconception. Spirituality means you have to give up our life and practice only devotional service. But here in this verse 13th page, Krishna is trying to make free us from this misconception. He is saying that Tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mam anusmara yuddhacha maya arpita mano buddhir mam eva shasi asamshyaha. So many people, if devotional service means you have to give, it never said like that. So suppose somebody is a doctor, he can continue his profession as a doctor but bring this knowledge into part of his life, then life will become happy, successful. Based on this knowledge only, his action will be perfect. That's why whatever occupation we are doing, we have to continue in our occupation. Whether somebody is a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, whatever class one may be, he can continue his class. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says in as Sthane Stita. Sthane means the place. Stita means be in your place. Whatever you are a teacher or a doctor or a lawyer or a working man, whoever may be, you have to continue your profession and bring this knowledge in your as a part of your life. This is the main intention of the Bhakti Yoga, spirituality. Nowhere it says that you have to give up your life, you have to suddenly stop all your activities. No, continue whatever you are doing, but only bring this knowledge as part of your life. That help us do a better job in our day-to-day life and handle situations in a better manner, because we get the higher knowledge, higher intelligence by reading the scriptures. Thank you. Hare Krishna.